In this video, we're going to discuss Cognos Analytics basic navigation, basic interface. So right now, as you can see, I'm in a welcome page, and the welcome page contains several areas. Well, in the middle here, in the middle section, I see a little tile for each file that I had recently opened. In here, I have some links to documentation and the getting started videos. Now, the important part is on the left panel in here. I have several areas. First area is my content. What I see in my content is the files that only I can access. My classmates cannot access it. No one else except me. I'm the only one who can modify them. I'm the only one who could delete them and create them, all right? So that's my content. As you can see, if I already did some work, it's gonna appear here, the files, my files. So here, each file has a different icon depending on the file type, whether it's a data set, data module, or if it's a data exploration, or it's a dashboard or story, right? We're gonna look at each later. Now in here, this is a team content. So this is the area, the shared files. Those are the files that were either pre-installed when the Cognos was set up, or the files uploaded by instructor or by administrator, Cognos Analytics administrator, specific for this course. Anything that's in the team content will be available to all of you, right? It's shared for all of you. What you see in here, calendars, get started, sample, and templates, those are pre-installed, but this folder is what I installed for you. I'm Cognos Analytics System Administrator, and I'm the one who loaded this for you. So if you click inside the folder, you see different subfolders, right? And there is a subfolder for each assignment. So here, this is where your data is for getting started assignment. This here is your data for assignment two, and et cetera, right? So in here, what you see is a path, right? The steps, how did I get to this file? So if I expand this panel, look, I see that I'm now in the team content in the data 610. See, this is the subfolder, all right? So I can click back to return to the root folder of the team content, right? I'm gonna close this out. What else do you see in here? Recent, this will list all files that you recently opened. In my case, well, I created something like a data module that I'll show you how to create in another video. And it's gonna show in here, it's gonna show here in the recent, and also I will see the tiles, the tile in here, okay? So if I was going to use this file to create dashboard, to create an exploration, I can either use it here, right? Or I can do it, access it from recents, or I can also access from my content, right? So what you could also do is, in your content, you have an option if you want to sort. As you keep working on it, you're gonna have more files, right? So when you click on sort, you have an option to sort the files by name or the file type or when they were modified, ascending, descending as well. What else you could do is you could create a new folder and save the files associated with assignment, a specific assignment into the folder. So for example, let me create a folder called assignment two, right? I created a folder called assignment two and I can save the data or I can save the files that I create for assignment two inside that folder, all right? If I wanted to. At the moment, there is nothing in the folder. Now, what else you could do in here? You could filter your content. If I click on the funnel, I can choose to display only folders, or if I want to see only the data, perhaps, right? Because when you work, if keep working on it, you're gonna have more files, right? So it will be a little bit harder to scroll through. So you have this option. You can also filter by way when the file was modified. For example, right now I just created my exploration, but I don't know what I called it. So I can filter this list and I can see only what I created or last modified today. See this? Or if I worked on something yesterday, well, which I did not here, but I could select yesterday, I have option past week and et cetera, or all. All right. Now, also I have an option to see perhaps if I want to do just data, right? That's another option. Okay, I'm going to uncheck. Or if you have a filter selected, another way to undo the filter is to click here. This will unfilter it. Okay, or I click on clear all. See this, I click on clear all and it will unfilter, it will remove the filter. Now, what else do you have? For the folder, you have this option. You can see the folder properties, right? Okay, what else? The properties include names. So to rename the folder, you would open properties, you would click on this pencil, and then you would enter a new name, all right? Now, the folder owner, well, in this case, it's gonna be you. And here is the date when the folder was created and modified. What else I could do is I could delete the folder, but please be careful, because once you delete the folder, it's permanent. All files that were saved inside that folder would be deleted as well. So when you delete something, beware, it's permanent, all right? So here it is. Now, the options that you see depend on the type of file that you're looking at. For example, I can edit data module, I can create an exploration, right? So this is my data module. This is a different menu here. Now, another point that I wanted to make is that if you delete the data module, right, all explorations, all dashboards where you use the data module as a source will become invalid permanently. So please be careful if you do the deletion. Now, what else you have in here is that you can search, right? So if, for example, if I type in here claims and weather, what it will do is it will list the files with these names that I have access to. And also here, it shows me where the file is located. If it's under my content or if it's in a subfolder in the team content, what you do not see is that you do not see the files that your classmates created in their content area, all right? And I could save my searches if this is a search that I run frequently, or I could further filter my search results. Like over here, for instance, I can limit the results to what the files that I modified today. I can do all, right? Or over here, I could specify perhaps that I want only data, right? And etc. So I have an option to filter the results further. Now I'm gonna click clear all. Now to undo the search, you're gonna click here on this X. This will undo the search. Going back to my content. All right, now avoid using the browser back button. You use this here menu to navigate through open files. Right now, I don't have anything open, right? So let's see, let's open this data module as an example. Now, if I was going to return to the welcome page without closing this data module, this is what I do. I click on this arrow and I select this from this dropdown, okay? Now, what else you can do? Well, let me show you another example. Suppose that I went ahead and let me just modify it. I'm just going to click on this column. And just for the purpose, I'm just going to do, well, I'm going to do something. Now, look, I made a change. Every time when you make a change to the file, if your change is not saved, you're going to see this little asterisk next to the file name. So if you see that asterisk, it means that your file was not, your file was modified and not saved, all right? So here I can click home, it will take me to the welcome page. So if I'm inside another file to go back to the welcome page, I have two options. Option one, I can click on this home and this button available anywhere. It's available in data module. It's available if you are in exploration, right? I can return home this way. Alternatively, I can select welcome. I can select welcome from this dropdown, all right? So now if I try to close that file, well, it's giving me an option. I'm gonna do close without saving for right now. What else you see here is that there is a link to documentation over here, right? Then in here, you can sign out, right? Well, that's basically all, okay? So that, oh, over here is a new menu. You can use that to create your dashboards, explorations, etc. You can, and I'll show you in other videos how, but if you use them, if you create them from this menu, then you would need to specify the data source. All right. Thank you very much for watching this video. That was an introduction to Cognos Analytics Navigation.